Hello, I'm Muthu, a cloud support engineer here at the AWS office in Bangalore, India. Sometimes customers ask me how to authorize Amazon API Gateway APIs using custom Amazon Cognito scopes. I tell them by making a few configurations to Amazon API Gateway and Amazon Cognito, we can provide differentiated access to Amazon API Gateway resources based on Amazon Cognito custom scopes. So today, I'll be showing you how to do it. Let's get started.
Before we begin the setup, here are a few prerequisites. An Amazon Cognito user pool set up with a domain name and an app client for the hosted UI. An Amazon API Gateway with at least one resource and one method for that resource. Our setup is divided into two parts. Creating a resource server and custom scope in the Amazon Cognito user pool and allowing it for our app client. Then, creating an Amazon Cognito authorizer for our API gateway and then associating our resource method with an Amazon Cognito custom scope that is verified by the API gateway before allowing access to the requested resource. Once we finish our setup, we will also test it so that we can verify that it works without any issues. Now, let me walk you through the setup. After logging into the AWS Management Console, go to the Amazon Cognito console and select your user pool. Now, choose the resource servers under App Integration section. Choose Add a Resource Server. Now set up the resource server. For name, enter a friendly name for the resource server, such as a weather API. For identifier, enter a unique identifier for the resource server. This could be an HTTPS endpoint where our resource server is located. In our case, this could be the HTTPS endpoint for our API gateway, where our API resources are located. For scope name, enter any scope name. For example, weather.re. For the scope description, give a brief description for the scope. For example, retrieve weather information. Choose Save Changes. Choose the App Client Settings under App Integration section now. Now go to the App Client Settings of your hosted UI. Under Allowed Custom Scopes, check the box for the newly created custom scope. Choose Save Changes. Now, let's see the configurations required on the API Gateway side. Go to your API in the API Gateway console. Then, from the main navigation page, choose Authorizers under your specific API. Under Authorizers, choose Create New Authorizer. Enter an authorizer name in the name section. Select the Cognito option. Choose a region under Cognito user pool. Select an available user pool. You must have created a user pool for the selected region in Amazon Cognito for it to show up in the drop-down list. For token source, enter authorization as the header name to pass the access token that's returned by Amazon Cognito when a user signs in successfully. To finish integrating the user pool with the API, choose Create. Now, go to Resources and select the method name. Then select Method Request Configuration. Select the Cognito Authorizer in Authorization dropdown. This action automatically adds a new field called OAuth Scopes. Enter the full identifier for the custom scope in the required format. The format for a custom scope is Resource Server Identifier / Scope Name. Remember to save using the checkmark and then deploy the API. We can now test the setup using Postman or curl. First, let's get the access token from Cognito authorization server using one of the OAuth2 flows defined for the client. For example, you could use the Cognito hosted UI to retrieve the user's tokens. Now we have the retrieved access token. We'll send this received access token as the authorization header in the request to API Gateway. We'll use curl to send the request. Now we can see that if everything is successful and the API Gateway can validate and verify the access token and the required custom scope, then you get a 200 OK response. In conclusion, using custom scopes with Amazon Cognito and the API Gateway helps us provide differentiated levels of access to our API resources in an easy and reliable manner.
Thanks for watching, and happy cloud computing from all of us here at AWS.